Hi, I'm Patrick McColery, and I'm playing the man in All Blues.
Hi, I'm Dorothy, and I'm playing We Are Healed in All Blues.
And I am Johnell Easter, and I'm playing Slight in All Blues.
So how'd you find out about this play?
I was on a movie set and got a call from... I'm just joking. I actually saw Dale. We had this kind of like networking venue where we were putting things together to help theater out, ideas of travel, things of this nature, what we could do for housing, all these things that we could do just to help theater we don't think about every day. And he comes to me and tells me he got this great play, and he wanted me to read it, come in and do the read, so Dale invited me, man. So it was great to have him invite me.
And I was working here at the theater, Seven Stages Youth Creates, a wonderful program for children. And Dale, similar to you, said, hey, I got something I want you to read. And I read it, and I fell in love. It's all the jazz standards I grew up loving. So, yeah, that's me.
Same with me. Dale Hamilton sent me an email. I worked here at Seven Stages last spring.
Yeah.
At a collaboration with Haverty Marionettes called The Color of Her Dreams, and that led to him sending me an email and said, are you available? And he sent me the script, and I read it, and I had met Robert Earl Price, the playwright, before, and had read some of his work before, so I was excited to get it and read it. That's how we ended up here.
Oh yeah, it was a cool process. Yeah.
It's a really interesting process because it's double cast, and it's a collaboration with Washington College in Maryland, and they went up there, Dale went up there, and some of the folks from Seven Stages, they rehearsed, yeah. Mm-hmm. They just ran a weekend up there, and now they arrived this week. They're teching right now, and then we sort of get to tech next week, and they run the first weekend, and then the Atlanta cast runs the second and third weekend.
So it's like tag team theater,
mm-hmm.
or relay theater, pass mm-hmm. the baton theater. It's really cool. This is the first time in my career that I've ever actually had this type of experience, and I am really excited about how it's going to continue to enrich my life to learn in this process, because sometimes you start, and that's what I love about Seven Stages as well, sorry, backtracking, because it's non-traditional casting, it's a different type of familial, like once you're in, you're in
familiarity.
they'll use you, and you know, especially, and they know your skill set, so they'll call you in for the pieces that they know you can grow in, so. Awesome.
Really nice. Mm-hmm. So you can imagine in this process, there's not a lot of time to learn lines. So that's what's mostly different for me. I've been having the pleasure of having at least 2 weeks to learn lines, but this process, man, we're gonna have to dive on in, go deep, and fight it out. And that's what theater's all about. Shifting and changing. There's no take two on the stage. So this particular process is indicative of theater, because it's time to jump in and adjust. It's a new process to me, I think to Patrick and Dee as well.
Never before, yeah.
And we're having to adjust. And this is the making of great actors. So we're here for the learning, man. We want to learn. We want to become great. So, you know.
And the story is just fascinating. It takes place in 1949. It's inspired by a true story of a reporter that came down from Pittsburgh, I believe. And his name is Ray Spriggle, and he masqueraded as a black man in the South during Jim Crow laws. And the play is sort of a poetic rumination of what that experience might have been like for him. And there's lots of fantastic music. Miles Davis,
Coltrane, Randy Newman.
And, yes. Dorothy gets to sing, and she's an incredible, unbelievable jazz singer. And then we also have Mike Molina, who's a spoken word artist and a drummer, and Dell is the center of the whole experience. We have a chorus of young people who are fleshing out the stage. But it's really just a fascinating kind of... thought process.
Yeah.
Putting it all together. It's
process is poetry, you know, the process, and just being observant of things now, you know, we're kind of seeing it happen, because they've been in Maryland last few weeks or whatever, so we've been kind of down here and kind of just feeling the energy, but now we're all together, we're seeing the characters, we had a chance to actually see a video of the piece, so, you know, we're becoming in touch with it, we're forming a bond, and it's going to be interesting, man, and I'm ready for the ride.
Very, very timely.
Absolutely.
Very timely subject matter.
Yeah.
Socially, politically, and it's heavy, but that's what the beauty of the music does. It's like a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, mm-hmm. and it's informative. And I hope that everybody comes to see this and talk about it and learn from it and start healing.
That's right.
Absolutely. Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah, because when Ray did his
thing, the healing.
Yeah, and he got a chance to live it firsthand. You know, he had a different perspective going back up to Pennsylvania, you know, a whole different perspective of what was going on about the Jim Crow laws and things of that nature. So it's something that we need to continue to do. In theater, we want to teach, we want to inspire, we want to make you happy, we want to make you cry. But this particular piece right here entails all of that, but it's to teach so that we can kind of have that same experience that Ray went through on his own. You know, he decided to do that in a time period where he could have been killed, jailed, anything of that nature, and won a Pulitzer, you know? So the play speaks volumes, and I think all ages can enjoy it, to learn from it, take something away, and possibly we could help change society. You know what I'm saying? We think big, man.
That's what we do.
Yes.
And it's you know, just we were talking earlier that, you know, this is about a specific period in time, but it really was only yesterday in the big scheme of things, and that wound is still part of who we are as Southern people. And that's why I love being able to participate in pieces like this, because it's an opportunity to cleanse that wound. And it reminds me actually of Gem of the Ocean, and there's August Wilson in here as well, because it really gives us that opportunity to open something that is actually still open, but to take a look at it and really try and come to some understanding, I think.
Absolutely, I agree. Take the sugar off.
Mm-hmm.
It's time to take the sugar off, man, and know that what the Jim Crow laws had done to us as a society, not just black people, but white people, mm-hmm. Spanish people, anybody that was around during that time, because it all affected you in some sort of way, in the way you would think, in the way you would perceive other people, not giving someone a chance, not going for character, things of this nature. And even today, we still are just very judgmental.
And we still have those laws. We have antiquated Jim Crow laws on the books that a lot of people don't realize, but they're still in act. They're still in action. These antiquated Jim Crow laws are affecting lots of people.
Mm-hmm. Even today.
Even
literally today.
Like what's going to happen tomorrow?
You know.
As heavy as all that is, that the piece itself is so lyrical and beautiful. Like you said, a spoonful
spectacle
of sugar.
Is beautiful. If you like to see beautiful things, you're going to see this. It's beautiful. The designer, Faye.
Yes.
Awesome. I love it. It's so good.
And it's performed without an intermission, so which is lately seems to be the thing. So if you want a great night of theater that is gorgeous to look at and is held together by the extraordinary talent of Dale Hamilton, mm-hmm. you need to come on out and check it out.
Oh, yeah. Just make sure you have a little potty break before you come in.
Exactly.
Because we're not stopping, man. We're not stopping. We're going all the way through today.
That's right.
Absolutely. I guess we'll see you guys there.
Yeah. We'll see you at All Blues.